Well, the Armed Forces of the Philippines asserts the latest incident involving Philippine and Chinese ships will not stop the country from conducting more resupply missions. Katrina Domingo on the line now to tell us more about that. Kat, over to you.
Hi, Carmina. The Philippines will continue conducting regular air and sea patrols independently. That's what Armed Forces of the Philippines spokesperson Colonel Francel Padilla said days after the Chinese vessels collided with several Philippine Coast Guard ships in Philippine waters. Padilla confirmed that the United States had offered to assist the Philippines in rotation and resupply missions several months ago or some time ago, but she underscored that the Philippines would rather that the armed forces would do their RORA missions independently. She says RORA missions are quite important for the Philippines because the country wants to capacitate itself in doing this mission independently. She says, our troops are the ones that are involved, our vessels are the ones that are involved, and therefore the Philippines need to do this mission by itself and also so as not to escalate tensions in the West Philippine Sea. Carmina, the AFP says it is closely coordinating with the PCG on how they will be assisting them in any way that they deem necessary. But so far, the PCG has yet to file a request with the AFP in terms of their operations in the area where the Chinese vessel collided with our ship. Carmina.
Thanks a lot, Victoria Tula there joining us on the line. Senator Rizzo Ontivero says the Philippine government has sought the help of the Interpol in the escape of dismissed Mayor Alice Guo and her siblings. Victoria Tula on the line now with details. Victoria, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, in a press conference this morning, Senator Rizzo Ontivero said the Department of Foreign Affairs has reported to the Philippine Center on Transnational Crime, which is the Philippine arm of the International Criminal Police Organization, or Interpol, the passports of dismissed Mayor Alice Guo and her siblings, Sheila and Wesley's alleged girlfriend, Catherine Cassandra Ong. Ong is the authorized representative of Lucky South 99, the illegal Philippine offshore gaming operator, or POGO, in Porac, Pampanga. Ontivero said it is up to Interpol to determine what specific action it will take on the case of Guo. She surmises that they may issue a blue or red notice, which will mandate member countries to help arrest the dismissed mayor. Ontiveros is still verifying where Guo and her family are now. She is still looking also into how they could have possibly left, especially since they are the subject of an immigration lookout bulletin order. The senator said they will thoroughly investigate this in the hearing of the Subcommittee on Justice scheduled next Tuesday, August 27. One of those who will be invited is Guo's counsel, attorney Stephen David, who said yesterday that he believes his client is still in the Philippines based on their latest conversation. Officials from various agencies will also be called, such as those from the Bureau of Immigration. Ontiveros believes someone helped Guo escape. The hearing of the Subcommittee on Justice is different from the two or three more hearings that Ontiveros' Committee on Women will still conduct in relation to Guo and POGOs. The DFA has also informed Ontiveros that it has included Guo and her relatives in its passports watchlist database to prevent the issuance of a new passport to them. Carmina?
Thanks a lot, Victoria Tula, there joining us on the line. The Aquino family and their supporters marked the 41st anniversary, make that death anniversary of the late Senator Ninoy Aquino with a mass at the family mausoleum in Manila Memorial Park. Our very own Izzy Lino joins us with that story. Izzy, over to you.
Carmina, former Senator Bam Aquino and other personalities gathered at the Aquino Mausoleum in Manila Memorial Park on Wednesday to commemorate the 41st anniversary of the martyrdom of former Senator Benigno Ninoy Aquino Jr. The memorial mass was held amidst discussions surrounding the recent decision by President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. to move the commemoration of Ninoy Aquino Day from August 21 to August 23. However, Aquino expresses mixed feelings about the decision, saying holiday economics have been done by several presidents. But as a family member, it's more meaningful to commemorate Ninoy Aquino Day on the day he was actually assassinated. Historian Shao Chu acknowledged that while the date change could affect the day's significance, the public's respect for Ninoy Aquino's legacy could still amplify its impact. Bam Aquino also addressed rumors of a potential alliance between the Aquino and Marcos camps in the upcoming elections. He emphasized the importance of working together in issues that matter to people, but made it clear that he would be running as independent candidate alongside Senator Francis Pangilinan and human rights lawyer attorney Chel Jocno. Carmina?
Thanks a lot. Izzy Lee there joining us on the line. In entertainment, Jennifer Lopez has filed for divorce from Ben Affleck after just 2 years of tying the knot. That's according to multiple media reports. There have been months of speculation about the end of their marriage. They were pictured not wearing their wedding rings in numerous occasions. The pair started dating and was even engaged in the early 2000s. They split up and rekindled their relationship in 2022.